What's up, guys? We're back on the Madden 22 Ultimate Team. And we last left off and said I was going to do a team update. Like, I'm going to upgrade a team. Offense, pretty much the same. We got a new right tackle, though. Brian at 84. Colton at left tackle. Got him up to 87. That's pretty much the same. I think Christian Kirk might be new. I'm not even sure. I forget, man. I remember he spoke bad on this when I do a team update. But, yeah, moving over to the defense. This is where we made our bread and butter. Since that guy embarrassed us in that video, man. If you guys haven't seen that video, pretty sure it's episode 4. You guys are going to make me check now. Yeah, episode 4. Lower to the defense. Yes. It's nasty. At starting right in, we have Nick Bosa. 87 overall from the Oslo Buckeyes. Backing him up. 83 Chase Young, but it's okay. Defense tackle number 1, still the same. Everybody defense tackle still the same. Youngblood still there. JC Jackson. Got him powered up to 88. Everybody still the same. I think Darius Revis might be. We just threw him in there because he's the highest that we have left over. Move over to the linebackers. We have Corey still the same. Miles Jack. I forget if he was on the team. I don't think he was on the team yet. Zach Cunningham. Darius Leonard. I know for sure he's new. Tyron's still there. And we got Trayvon. Don't know how we got him. I logged on. No. Yes, I logged on. I stopped recording and logged on after that night when I was like, well, we need a new free safety because we was rocking Chase Young. Not Chase Young. Cam Chancellor. Logged on after that night after hopping on Fortnite. And we get helloed to this new rookie guard. So we gotta pick one, so I pick him. Yeah, so you know what time it is. Let's get to the games.
And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And we are underway from Cincinnati. Taking in at the 3. Oh, a good return up past the...
Oh!
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. And they'll run for the first time with Najee Harris. 5 yards on the game's first play.
Fight, young man, fight.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure you're back. You spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. 16 yards, a first down. With Harris out of the shotgun, and he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 11 more on that one, and another first down. Harris.
Ah.
And a short gain down to about the 33.
Hey.
Just a yard on the first down.
Aldridge really hasn't made a change besides, I think, upgrading two tackles we had, and who else?
He was fortunate to get in.
I think offensive line.
Flushed out right.
Nobody wants to help. Nobody.
Field, so he'll throw it away.
Help. I was trying to get him to come circle to move, but I think I could start controlling pitch.
Looking to throw is Mahomes.
Oh. Hits.
Oh.
Oh. Yeah.
33 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead.
What a weapon he he is at the tight end spot.
Oh, he hit my kicker.
They throw him the football downfield. They count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that.
Here's our real question. Is our defense, this guy is good on offense, is our defense going to be able to handle at least one or two stops? And we have to capitalize on those one or two stops. At least let them milk the clock a little bit and drive down their score. Not big plays. If we give up big plays, and it's just a fail.
Well,
thank you, 85. Thank you, 85. Whoever that was. Ebron, thank you. This Barkley's about to abuse us. There's no joke. Oh, that was the Ebron.
Tight end Charles in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass catching abilities, and they're able to continue to find him here in the early going. I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he
tackle Vita.
Vita Vea stopped that play in its tracks. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. They'll give it to Barkley off the
young blood. Come on.
And this one also slow and developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. Nothing there, no gain, and now they're looking at a third and 15. Jackson.
Pull me!
Darius!
Darius!
Picked off by Darius Leonard, the linebacker. Well, he had to fit that into a pretty tight window over the middle. And Charles, I think they were in zone defensively, weren't they?
They certainly were. Nice read on your part. And sometimes the quarterback isn't fooled between zone and man. Sometimes just fooled by the type of zone that he sees. Because oftentimes.
Good fucking block chase. Good block, Chase! Good block! Wow, that was a good block. That was a crazy good block.
They started this drive with terrific field position, and it's going to get even better after that play. Had great options with where they started, so they decided to press their advantage.
Weight room in this! We weight room in here! Come on! I love that Darius Leonard got that pick, man. New pickup. New pickup.
Yeah, it certainly does, because
I'm pretty sure Miles Jack was there too, but everything was happening so fast. Come on. Not done yet. Not even close.
Taken in at the 3. And he's going to be taken down on 1.
Because if it wasn't for 85, I think it was Njoku. I'm guessing it was Njoku because it's only 85 I've seen. So what's up for him slowing down Barkley for us? That drive is completely different.
Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception, but they did put together Charles a nice.
Oh my, how do you get away from that hit stick? How do you wiggle like that? You need to teach me your ways. That was a nice little wiggle. I didn't know how to do that. Teach me your ways, young man. Leonard! Come on, Darius! Put the both hands up, baby!
Knocked away and incomplete. Darius Leonard, the linebacker, able to break that one up. Second and 10. Jackson from the shotgun. Ballooning the pressure right. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down. Here's a give to Barkley.
Stuff him!
We're gonna mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. It's a pickup of 3, but it brings up what will be an interesting 4th and 1. Here's Jackson.
That's to his running back complete. Stackle. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time. He's tired, so. First and 10. To throw is Jackson. Flush to his right. Give me that! Darius, come on, baby! Darius! And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. So that now two consecutive drives that have ended in interception. Oh, my God. Ladies and gentlemen, we got Hawkinson, too. We got a new tight end on our team. There he is. Showing the weight room. Weight room mentality. If you're on this team, you have to have the weight room mentality. That's what I'm just telling you guys. But yeah, I forgot. He's like 85 now because I got him powered up too. We've been powering up. Fucking weight room, baby.
Yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. They'll roll him out right.
Wait room.
Taken down at the 35-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18
yards. Is he in here?
To throw, it's Mahomes. Escaping the pressure right. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Now Mahomes. He's going to rifle one deep left side.
Fudge. That happened in the Campus Legends too. That's my fault. That happens at the Campus Legends too. I think I can get it out there and just push it out to the corner, but it'll go out in the corner. Flush!
Maybe they got a little greedy.
Well, it is hard to blame them, isn't it? Because like they said back in the 1980s, greed can be good. Stick with what's been working. But that time, I think he got a little bit too much air under that one, and it turned into a turnover that was much needed by that defense.
Oh! Lillard was right there again. Oh my God, he was running for it. He should have died.
Hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well. You know, he's got to throw it better. Got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught.
Oh my Lord. Corey is there. I'm pretty sure that's Corey, man. Forget his first name. What was that? If we lose this game, it's my fault for that pick, man. We could have went up at least 17. I got greedy. Thinking I could push that.
And Jackson throwing once more. Buying time to his left.
No way, dude. No way. Who is that? Who's out there? I need you to go back. There's enough dudes out here chasing Jackson down.
Here's another first and 10. From the gun, it's Jackson.
Good ball. Good hits, boys. Good hits. Miles Jack and Leonard. Good hits. Come on.
He did a fine job there not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
To throw once more on second and 10, Jackson.
Good hits, Leonard.
Clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
How's that play working so effectively?
Inside the 10 to the 7. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half. Now Jackson. Flushed out right. And he's going to take it in.
Damn it.
Steeler touchdown. Lamar Jackson in the final seconds of the first half. And the Steelers are on the board here in the final seconds of the first half. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away. Oh, trying to gauge the sun and he muffs it. Oh, a good looking return set up here. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break.
This is not good.
That
one interception is going to cost us 14 points on the board. Wow!
On EA Sports, taking it about the one. And able to get this out.
Jesus, one interception that I just want. I just try to get a little bit free in the air with, man. Try to get a little bit free on the playmaking. And it's gonna probably come back and bite me right in my cheeks, man.
Short into the scoreboard here, Charles. What
that's tough.
If any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
One play.
The gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks. I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers a little bit more to the perimeter, perhaps. But above all, play your game.
From the 29, Jackson.
Good hit.
Complete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long game or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch.
No, 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 no. No way.
A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion.
No way.
On the other side of the field now, it's first and 10. As they've got things rolling on this drive. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. Not much there, only.
No way, bro.
Steps away to his left. Gets this out to Saquon Barkley. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside.
I don't know what happened there. I don't. Okay, we need a. I need to refocus. I just keep thinking about the interception, bro. That shit's pissing me off, bro. It all comes down to that fucking pick. It all comes down to that pick.
How do I get to him and get him on the ground? And guess what? That didn't happen, and his receivers took advantage.
And it's caught. It's Brown. Touchdown, Steelers. A.J. Brown there to make the grab. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. So he scrambled right but was able to look back toward the middle of the end zone to find the target.
As you know, in this game, sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules because we all know most guys throwing the football are taught never throw back into the middle of the field on a scramble. He did it and got away with it for a touchdown.
Instinct sometimes, right? They just take over.
Instinct and vision. Sometimes you just see people who are open, you're able to get it to them.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown a moment ago.
And that shouldn't change the mindset a whole lot from an offensive perspective because they already knew this was going to be a hard-fought game. Now they just need to go out, execute their game plan, and keep moving.
Rolling to his right.
No.
Ballooning
Hole?
To his right.
Hole?
All said and done. 27 yards there, a first down. Now left side on the swing pass. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Final minute now of the third quarter. To throw again on second down. Mahomes flush to his right.
Oh my God. Oh, I gotta take that off. I gotta take that off. That pissed me off.
Thomas. And that'll make it third down.
I gotta take that off. I gotta take that off. I gotta take this shit off. Wow.
My eyes gravitated downfield because now
it's not the first time Mahomes has done that to us, man.
Don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
That's caught left side of the tight end Pitts.
Pitts!
And they have themselves another first down as the tackle is made at the Steelers 16. A big play there as they get the conversion on 3rd and 13. So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. On the give, this is Harris.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, Najee Harris. He loved this man. We love this man here. Didn't get it.
Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at 3rd and 1. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And Harris is not going to get there. Great work defensively to stop him short. They end up getting stuffed twice after that 9-yard gain back on first down. Blankenship's kick is good.
Wow.
They take a 17-14 lead. So he waited on the sideline for his first chance in the ball game, and it didn't come until the fourth quarter, but he connects there. A big one to give him the lead.
Boy, you talk about coming in cold. I don't care how many times you kick it into a net. You're not really ready when you go out there. All that beef is coming at you trying to block the kick.
Good drive. Just
He delivers.
Hey, the pick could have been the same way, man. We could have had all those extra yards.
Themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game. 60 yards on the ground.
This is what we wanted, though.
The last run got six.
See if our defense can prove to us.
They'll go to Barkley again.
Oh my God, he's tired. He's tired. He's tired. He's tired. EA, he's tired. He's literally tired. He's hunched over. And he was in different animation when I blew his head off. Dude, EA, he's tired.
Jackson, and he's gonna have a first down.
EA, no way. There's no way. There's no way. If that's me, I'm fumbling. If that's me, I'm fumbling. I swear, if that's me, if that's anybody watching this video right now, that's you. You're fumbling the ball. You're fumbling the ball. We all know. We don't get that luck. No way.
Less than two to play with just a few
points.
So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset.
Lord have mercy.
They come up on a 1st and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Now this pass into the hands of Saquon Barkley. And the result here.
He's gonna get in the end zone. I can't stop him, man. I don't know. I think it's my playbook now. I think it might be my plays. It can't be the team anymore. Or we already made great plays in this game. We used them all, and then we couldn't capitalize on the third play that we got, and it's my fault. That interception is just gonna come down and it costs us the game. I said I wanted my defense to make plays. They did. They came out and made plays. They did just that. And now I'm fumbling the bag. I fumbled the bag for him. No fucking way. No way. Dude, he's right there. Come on.
On second down now. Barkley. And he'll only get a yard to bring up third and one.
Fucking right there.
We're going to get a timeout.
It's just the first. There's Miles Jack right there.
Here in the final stages. Pretty good job.
That's game.
He was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side.
I'm pissed, man. I'm pissed. Oh, God. That's...
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10.
I want to think that we're sitting heat.
Now Jackson, escaping the pressure right.
Easy. Too easy.
Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
Wow. I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say, the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
And a short kick taken at about the 16. Well, a dangerous return man showing it here.
I should have got that for more,
but as it is, still a good return. They'll start the drive right around the 37. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring, and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. Kyle Pitts, the intended receiver, and it's third and short. Mahomes to throw it.
What the fuck was that?
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown.
What was that? What was that?
Down four late, gotta go for it here on fourth down. They're going for it. This is Harris. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Here's Mahomes. And he'll just get rid of it. I see you nodding your head up and down. It's a very heady decision at this stage of the game. Out of the pocket, nowhere to go. Just get rid of it.
That's a smart play because you're not worried about your completion percentage, and you're also not trying to force it into bad traffic as well. Throw the ball away. Live to fight another down.
5 yards. Now it's third and five.
Oh, we see another pitching catch. I can't believe I lost that game. That pick really going to sit there and still that game like that.
There's a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Well, going into the final play of this game, wow, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end.
That fucking stings. We're back on the mound playing too often the team. Last game really stung in the heart a lot. Darius Leonard balled the hell out last game. Two picks. Could capitalize on one of them, sadly. We could have made it 21-0. Got a little bit greedy. I thought I could get it out left to Chase on a deep route, and again, it got picked. But I'm here. Just hop back into another game. That one really stung a lot, and no team up, no difference on the team, same thing. Really, yeah. Let's get into the games.